Let's imagine you have a franchise built on decades of timeless story and memorable characters. Your last two entries, while still decent, have met with criticisms, and you need one last game to end a trilogy. What would you do? If your answer is, make dozens of costumes, put them on your main character, and hope for God's sake she will carry your game, you're thinking like Square Enix. This is Lightning Returns Final Fantasy XIII, and honestly, it's not that bad. Now you might be thinking, that's a lot of faith and investment on just one character. Remember, this is Lightning. From early to middle of this decade, Lightning has fame and appeal more than any other Final Fantasy character. This is her appearance outside her main games, and the list still goes on. She also appeared on commercials and even has her own Louis Vuitton series. That's right, a fictional character promoting a real-life famous brand, along with Jaden Smith. If you didn't know that piece of information, I hope it will make your day. In Lightning Return, she's the chosen savior and only has 13 days to save as many people before the world is ending. And you can just feel the melancholy tone throughout the game. This is not the grand epic adventure Final Fantasy is famous for. This is a lonely last adventure of Lightning. It is her farewell. Appropriate, although maybe not intentional. To understand it better, we need to take a look back at the prequels. We'll get back to Lightning spin-off in a bit. It was the start of PlayStation 3, and as usual, Final Fantasy was the flagship title. It garnered such hype back then. We started with Lightning as a fugitive, fighting against literal gods to save her sister Sarah. After a long journey, she eventually succeeded, and all was well until the sequel, Final Fantasy XIII-2. Continuing right after the ending, Lightning was chosen as another god's champion, only to be frozen in the crystal just 5 minutes later. Here you took control of Sarah, and in the turn of event, she's now trying to save Lightning. Final Fantasy XIII-2 introduced time travel mechanic and highly convoluted story. I'll save some time, she didn't make it. Now we arrive at Lightning Returns. 500 years has passed, and the world is ending. This was also Square Enix's last game for PlayStation 3. A farewell for the generation, and gone were the hype and dazzle. In span of few years, many other titles like Last of Us and Bioshock Infinite have overshadowed Final Fantasy. To their defense, Final Fantasy XIII and also XIII-2 were not bad games, even though they had some harsh but fair criticism. Sure, Final Fantasy XIII was too linear, and XIII-2 had confusing story, but looking back, neither of those two were completely terrible. The gameplay was fun, visual was still great, and they had killer soundtracks. Regardless of the flaws, they still had good production value, and you might find something you like there. Personally, my biggest disappointment was they could have had a continuous storyline between the three games, as this was the first Final Fantasy trilogy. But of course, it didn't happen. I don't think Square Enix had planned that far into the third game. The sequels tried to do something new, so different than the previous title that it ended up feeling disorganized. The characters from two previous games barely remember who they are. In fact, each of them has a new subplot, and they retain so little of their, well, character. One of the better things about Final Fantasy XIII was, it's the story about a group of people. The game changed perspective multiple times, and by doing so, tell their struggle, sorrow, and guilt. At the end, they come to accept and rely on one another. For me, this journey of characters was the essence of Final Fantasy, the reason why I like this franchise so much. The addition of two more games should improve, not undermine this. For comparison, Final Fantasy XII came out at the end of PlayStation 2. The world was huge, and to this day, I couldn't believe they fit all of that in PlayStation 2. However, when playing Lightning Returns, instead of feeling like I'm going on an epic adventure, I just reflected, oh, so this is how it ends. This doesn't mean I dislike Lightning Returns. The combat was still enjoyable. Square Enix got this part right. It was dynamic, and they even managed to put costume change into the gameplay. The many costumes of Lightning also look great on her. They all have different appeal, some of them are important to the story, Some are just straight up fan service, like Lara Croft or Cloud Strife costume, although I'm not complaining. On the other hand, the environment only consists of 5 major locations. It is incredibly small for Final Fantasy, or any other RPG for that matter. They look pretty good for the most part, but you will run across bland segments or badly rendered NPC along the way. It happens often enough to be distracting. Furthermore, it has time limitations. One day in-game is equal to 72 minutes in real life, although there are ways to extend or pause this time limit. The system is actually decent. It gives the sense of urgency. Some events are only accessible on a certain time of the day, and enemies may be different depending on when you fight them. The idea was every playthrough would be unique, since your decision would affect the world. But in practice, only several quests would be interesting. The rest are just mundane fetch quests. They are not only boring, but they also cost you valuable time. On top of that, they force you to backtrack, which showcases the small scale of the locations. It just ends up exposing more bad sides instead of encouraging multiple playthroughs. Despite all this, I still had fun time with Lightning Returns. The last scene of the game was her riding a train in a new world, much like our own, and reflecting on her journey. After so many hours and through so many worlds, this is where her story concluded. And after accompanying her every step of the way, I just couldn't bring myself to dislike this game. I guess the moral of the story is, if you commit enough to your waifu, you might just make it work. That's it from me, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like, comment and subscribe. I make 3 videos every week. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one.